Hey guys, welcome to Indie Game Hustle. In this UModeler video, we're going to take a look at the loop slice tool. Go ahead and I have these three objects here. I have a cube, a sphere, and a cylinder. Nothing too special about those, but I'm going to go ahead and select one of these. And on the right side, if you go to the category add and all the way to the right, you're going to see the loop slice tool here. All right, so what you want to do is select that tool. And once you select that tool, it's really simple. All you have to do is hover over the object that you're going to loop through or create a loop for and click and click. And as you can see, it's creating basically in the center between the two edges there. Now, for more detail, what you can do is you can use the scroll wheel and you can increase those slices as well. So if you want to do something like that, that's pretty nice. Now, all it's really doing is increasing the split number. That's the same thing that's doing right here. So it's really just a split number. Now, another part is the pinch and the offset. I don't typically use that, but for the most part, all that is if you use this, you can pinch, like you can have it pinch more to the right or to the left and have it be a little bit more tighter. You can do the same thing with offsetting it. So you can offset it that way or offset it this way. It's kind of up to you based on your needs. It's just really the whole point is this is understanding how these tools kind of work and knowing that they exist. All right, so I'm going to set these back to zero. And of course, that will work the same way on another object like a sphere. So if we wanted to select loop tool, we can work on that as well. So in this case, the loop tool only will loop there because it gets stopped there. So we can do something like this, or if we go around it, we can do something like that. So it's just kind of up to you how that works. It's pretty cool. And the same thing for the cylinder, same process, select it and then hover and you can create loops that way. All right, well, that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks, bye.